outside, my school stuff was good, even though I was slow at writing. I feel good, I look good, I did my makeup, and I feel confident. Even though I have some pimple here and there, but this will go away soon, it's alright. So I feel like I'm gonna do a makeup collection today. I hope you guys will enjoy it. This video is getting everywhere, so we should start it now. So I'm sitting by my vanity table. This is where most of my makeup are. Let me take you closer. So looky here, so many beautiful makeup. I like makeup very much, it's one of my favorite things. I started wearing and started learning makeup when I was 14. So here I have my NARS blush. This is the color Outlaw. I've mentioned it in my videos before. My dad bought this one from Hong Kong. It's my first NARS blush. I think my first NARS product. I wanted to get Dolce Vita for autumn. It wasn't there. And I wanted to get Amore. It wasn't there. Many things were sold out. NARS was really popular in Hong Kong. It's a burgundy pink with some golden shimmer in it. And then we have Benetint. This is my Fenty Beauty Diamond Balm. Have you watched my Fenty Beauty Diamond Balm makeup look? I did my diamond look because I like this highlighter so much. And I really like how the look turned out. It looks really beautiful. It's shimmery, it's glittery, it feels wet, feels like ice cream when you rub it with your hands on it. Look how wet that looks. It goes on your skin super pretty, it's kind of blinding, kind of transparent, it's just magic. Next one we have is 3C eyeshadow palette. This is from my friend. She bought a NARS Skin Deep palette and she said I can take one of her eyeshadows. Sorry, I pressed the wrong button, I pushed the shutter button. So I broke this shade here, the glitter one, and this glitter one here. But I pressed them back, they were so soft like mochi. I like the colors and some beautiful mattes and shimmers. Let's put it all back. I like to get things organized. This is Bad Girl Bare Mascara from Benefit. Honestly, I don't like the mascara so much. This is a volumizing mascara. The ones I need is a curling mascara. So I apply this, my lashes fall down and so. But even so, I don't like it so much. I keep using it because I like the brand Benefit. I love their brand very much. This is the NARS Creamy Radiant Creamy Concealer. It's the first one I bought in our NARS shop here. It's in the shade Custard. This is my favorite bronzer. Hoola from Benefit, everybody use it. I get it to a birthday or Christmas it was. I ordered a set with 4 things inside. The set was called War Cat Girl. And then this came with a blue makeup bag. There was 4 minis inside. And this was one of them. Even so it was a mini, I thought this would be finished soon. I thought I could use this up and then if I like it, I buy the full size one. But after 2 years, this isn't used. Here on the left side, I keep all my eyeliners, gel eyeliner or liquid eyeliner. I have Maybelline, I have Kiss Me. And on the right side, I keep my eyebrow pencils. This one is from Shu Umura. It's very scratched, it's very popular in Asia. A friend gave it to me because she changed her hair color, so she don't need this one anymore. And then this one is from Innisfree. I still have a new one inside. This is a Goof Proof Brow Pencil. It's from Benefit. And I'm in the shade 4. So here's the eyeshadow palettes I have here. Peach Farm from Etude House. I did a video with a Peach Farm palette, it got really popular, over 100 views, but sadly, I look back to it and I realize you can't see anything when I'm doing the video, the lighting was really bad and so I think maybe I should refilm my video one day. And then this, I got Christmas last year. The ColourPop Disney Designer Collection and all the princesses are on it, look so beautiful. What is your favorite Disney princess? My favorite is Cinderella, this one here, they made her dress a little different, looks more mature and adult than fairy tales. On the top we have mattes, in the middle we have shimmers, in the bottom we have dark colors. So now we are moving forward to my lipstick collection. Normally this is what you have the most, lip products. The first makeup collection videos I watch is from big YouTubers I watch. Their makeup collection is mostly lipsticks. They have like 800 lipsticks in their storages. And when I watch it, I kind of feel uncomfortable. Knowing that you can only put one or two lipsticks on your lips at a time, you could never finish 800 lipsticks, so they're gonna end up throwing a lot away and feels uncomfortable. But anyway, this is my lip collection. After I watched big YouTubers' videos, it's been a very long time since I watched a makeup collection, but a few weeks ago, I watched one from a small YouTuber, and I felt happy watching, because her makeup is mostly in so a small makeup collection like mine, and she didn't have much. She was so passionate about each product, so that's what I try to share with you guys, the products that I really love, and it isn't much. I haven't bought makeup for a very long time already. The first one is a lip gloss from Dior. It's really pretty, but it goes on your lips kind of disappointing because they have no color, just few glitters in it. Here's two Chanel lip glosses. They are cocoa lip gloss. This is the first one I've ever bought with my money. My first lip gloss my parents bought was from Estee Lauder. I remember it very well still. It was a lip gloss, but I don't remember the color, the name, or anything anymore. Only the price was 250 RMB. This one is the shade 172. When I started wearing makeup, I go to the Chanel counter and bought this one. It was new at the time. And then the other two is from my mom, a Chanel lip gloss and the Dior 999 liquid matte lipstick. It's the legendary red. And then this one, I got it along with my NARS blush from Hong Kong. It's the NARS Power Matte Lip Pigment. When you swatch it on your hand or on your lips, it goes super wet like water. Then you thought this would be moisturizing. But then after a few seconds, it dries down and goes super dry. I always wear a lip balm under it and it still goes on full on matte. So it's very dry. You should wear a lip balm under it. It's in the shade You Are No Good. When my dad was in Hong Kong and he was video chatting with me and he showed me the color, I directly go on the NARS website to see what for color is You Are No Good. And they said a bright reddish fuchsia. When I heard fuchsia, I thought this was going to be a purple lipstick. But it's not. It's a reddish pink color. The other one I mentioned in my video before too, it's a Chameleon Dark Blue Purple Greenish Multi-Chrome Lip Gloss. It smells like mint chocolate from MAC. They are Grand Illusions. The color is called Sensory Overload. And then we have two MAC lipsticks here, Chili and Freckle Tone. Chili is a reddish orange color. It's a very popular color. Freckle Tone is a discontinued nude color. I got this from a friend. It's almost done, as you can see. A friend gave it to me. Chili is one of the most popular colors from MAC. I got it to Christmas. It looks like this. This is a lipstick from YSL, their shiny collection. I have another one. So other than this, I have also this little makeup bag here from Chanel. It can fit three lipsticks and I always put it in my bag. I chose three lipsticks I have to take out with me and I always have it. There's a mirror inside, so it's very easy for touch-ups. This is in the shade 15. I used it in my last video and this is in shade 12. It's a bright coral color, just like on the packaging. It's a shiny lipstick, it feels a little bit oily. The color is very bright, so it's good for summer. The other one I have here is Charlotte Tilbury in the shade Walk of Shame. It's also from a friend. She bought Walk of Shame and Pillow Talk, and she feels this doesn't look so good, so she gave it to me. It was very new. I exchanged with her, actually, with my YSL red lipstick. My lipstick was almost done when I gave it to her. She gave me a brand new lipstick. I like the color, I like the formula. This was a really comfortable matte formula. I like it very much, and it smells amazing too. So moving forward here. My friend also gave me this one. It's a Chanel lipstick in the shade 99 called Pirate. It's a sateen red. I don't like sateen reds. I like mostly matte reds, but sometimes when I feel very confident and feel I'm in a good mood, then sateen reds are okay too. And then we have Tom Ford. She also gave me this one because she had the exact same color but a new lipstick of it. This is in the shade Ruby Crush. It's almost done. I tried this formula. It's good, but it's definitely not worth the price. I know Tom Ford lipsticks are so super expensive. So let's put it back. I know I'm wasting a lot of time taking out things and putting back things, but I like to keep my makeup organized. The other one is my mom's favorite Holy Grail product. My mom don't wear much makeup, but her favorite is the Chanel Crayon Socios Eyebrow Pencil and this one, the Dior Lip Maximizer. And then let's moving down. Here I have three single eyeshadows from Etude House. This is a Kiss Me Mascara. It's super waterproof. I'm wearing it today. It keeps your curl up. It takes super long to wash it off. This one is a eyeshadow pencil. It's in a glittery color. In Asia, people have a trend. They like to put this in their tear dot. I think it's called aerosol also, the inner part of your eye, and then this will look a little bit glittery there. It gives you the puffy eye look, and some people like to wear it under their eyes because it looks like they just cried, but people like to put this under their eyes. So next one is a NARS eyeshadow palette. It's also from my friend who gave me this and this. I think I should appreciate much more and invite her for Starbucks or orange juice maybe. Thank you, Audrey, if you're watching this. So this is NARS eyeshadow. She gave it to me. She bought it, and I think she said anything like it doesn't look good on her. So both are shimmery colors. The eyeshadow is super creamy, but the colors are very pigmented. So when it goes on your eyes, maybe too much, you need to take every time only a little bit on your eyes. Then moving on to the second one. She gave me this, and she gave me this too. So this is 3CE blush I use in my back to school makeup video. I remember all my videos very well, it seems. It's in the shade You Make Me Blush. And this one is a 3CE color. 3CE come out with new products all the time. This one is already old. It comes with a little brush, a little mirror, and it's a highlighter in the shade Golden Pink. This is many people's holy grail and favorite concealer. It's from Maybelline called the Age One. I'm in the shade Neutralizer. Here we have some lip products. Two is from Victoria's Secret, my dad brought from Hong Kong. I like it very much. This one is a velvet matte. It's like a blotted lip. And this one is a nude color in the shade Adored. I was also wondering where is the shade or the color. And I got Google to search this one in the shade Adored. But the shade name was on the barcode, which I scratched off when I got it. This one is from 3C, also from my friend. It smells very sweet. I want to swatch it for you guys. So this is a lipstick. It's a kind of orange peachy nude color. It looks like this. It smells very sweet, like vanilla or like cake. It's very sweet, so if you are very sensitive to smells, you maybe don't like it, maybe it smells too strong. I'm not sure how long the video is going to be. I always keep my videos under 10 minutes, but we will see. This is a lipstick from Maybelline, Superstay Matte Ink. It's in a bright purple color. This lipstick stays on your lips for up to 16 hours. After you put it on, it feels super sticky. Many people say it's their favorite lipsticks, but when I put it on, honestly, it's very, very sticky. I'll try to blot off a little bit. After a half hour or so, the stickiness will go down, and when you smudge your lips, or no matter what you do to your lips, after 5 minutes, this will never go off. So I like it, actually. It goes on very well. But if you're eating burger, some will fall off. But it's much stronger, long-lasting than other lipsticks. This is also from my friend. It's from Sephora in the shade 17. It's a long-lasting lip stain. It's a dark red color. So here, I haven't bought makeup for a very long time because I realized I have too much makeup that I couldn't finish, but I exchanged for this 3 months or 2 months ago. This is from Maybelline. Maybelline have a program where every month you can use your points to exchange for a product. Last year, the whole year long, they didn't have it, and this year it came back, so I'm starting to use it again. This is the green eyeshadow palette. It's called Urban Jungle. Yes, Urban Jungle. So here's a MAC lipstick, also from my friend. It's in the shade Candy Yum Yum. In China, they call it Dead Barbie Pink. Because this kind of color doesn't look on Chinese skin tones, which is a little beige, a little bit white, so many people don't like it because it's too bright. They call it Dead Barbie Pink. Even if you don't like a lipstick, you don't have to install it so much, you know. And this one, my friend gave it to me too. 3CE lipstick. It's a matte one and it's a bright, bright orange color. I don't know what's with her. Maybe at that time she liked bright colors, so she bought a bright pink one and a bright orange one. And then my friend gave me this one too. She gave me a lot of makeup. This is from Chemic. It's their Glow Fleur Cheeks. It's flower petals blush. It has 5 different colors. 4 is blush, 1 is highlighter. It comes with a soft brush. I like Chemic. Chemic is literally the only one makeup brand that can make plastic look like crystal. I like their drugstore products. This is shade 8. It was new at the time. This is the Master Chrome Highlighter from Maybelline. It's very shimmery and glittering if you're under the right light. It's a little dark for me, but if I'm wearing bronzer, then this will work. I'm wearing it today. Looks like this. It's very blinding, but like many people have problems with it, if you have fair, white skin, then this won't work. This one I had pan on already. I exchanged with my points from Innisfree. It's a cream blush in the shade 4, Velvet Strawberry. This my friend just gave me like 2 days or 3 days ago. Oh. She got it from a friend and she thinks this is too red. Oh, wrong side. So that's how it looks. Looks almost like the Chemic one with some red blush shade and then a highlighter to it. I see this Anna Sui come out already with a new blush, so this one's old and maybe discontinued. My mom used to tell me how she used to use Anna Sui makeup. She bought like a powder compact with a fluffy powder puff. She told me when I was a kid, I asked her, can I have the puff? Then mom told me that I can have it as soon as she finished the powder. And then it seems like I dusted all the powder off the toilet also. So I gave her an empty compact bag and I took the puff. And my mom was very angry. I don't remember anything what she said, but she told me. This one is also from my friend. She bought 2 blush when the NARS store opened. One was Orgasm, one was Tauze. And this is Tauze. It's a little lighter than my other blush and the shimmers are a little more thinner or more fine, the shimmers. Here I keep my cotton pads, and here's all my makeup samples, which was a lot. I take some of them to traveling, then I put it in there, and then I go out with it. This is my MAC Fix Plus, 2 nail polish removers from Innisfree, only in new packaging. This too is also from my friend, the Dior Loose Powder. This one, it seems to be the old one from their LeBlanc powder. Here's all my nail polish and nail polish tools and stickers. This one is from Dior, it's gorgeous, I bought it 2 years ago. It's from their Christmas collection. It's very beautiful. It's a matte top coat with many golden glitters in it. Let's go down here. Here sometimes it gets messy, but I try to keep it clean every time. This is where most of my other lipsticks are. I try to keep them in this square here. 1, 2, 3, 4 from Maybelline. This one's from Maybelline too. And this is where my lipsticks are. This too is one of the first liquid lipsticks I bought. They're from NYX. This is exactly the color of my lips. This is the shade 9 Abu Dhabi. I mentioned both of them in my back to school makeup video. It's just things everywhere. I have some of my makeup here, some samples here, lip balm here, makeup tools here, as you can see. I tried the silicone puff. Silicone puffs aren't so good like they say. Some sponges, puffs, my Moa highlighter, the Innisfree powder, Innisfree cushion, the Maybelline strobing stick. This is the first highlighter I bought. It was a stick. because the powder version didn't came out yet. And they have some unopened makeup from Maybelline Innisfree. The brow pencil was buy one, get one. I'm sorry, I'm talking faster because I think the video is getting too long, but I should just be patient maybe. Even if the video is 20 minutes, I hope you guys watch it. So this is Vita Lumiere Glow. It's a cushion my friend bought for me. And this exchange this month from Maybelline, it's a Fit Me foundation in the shade 115. Little bit light for me, but this, after a while this will look okay. Kiss Me eyeliners, I have two of them, a brown one and a black one. Kiss Me is a very popular Japanese drugstore brand in Asia. My friend bought it every time for me when she's in other countries like Japan or maybe Hong Kong or maybe Macau. And this is Nude Sticks. It's a set from them. I bought it when it was on sale. Have 6 sticks inside. I took 2 of them out. One I give to my friend in the Sage Stiletto, and the others are here. Some skincare samples. Everyone having their storages. Here I have some other makeup. Hello, this is me. So I have a mirror here. And this makeup basically is too long, so I can't put them in drawers. This is a full-sized professional from Benefit. And this is a Maybelline BB cream. I know they look different in the US. It's a pink tube in the US. This is my Chanel foundation. It's the first foundation I bought with my money. And it costs a lot. So sometimes it's, I don't want to put it on my face because I feel like I'm putting money on my face. But actually, it took really long to finish the foundation. I'm wearing it right now. This is a Fenty Gloss Bomb in the shade Fenty Glow, the original one. When I bought it, there was only this color. And then next one is a face powder. That's the only thing that's easy to hit pan on. This is from Camic. And it's my second one. I can every time refill it, so when it's done, I take it out and I buy a new refill. And then we have two Chanel compacts. This one is from my birthday last year. I showed it in my videos too. It looks like this. It's from the Le Beige collection, which many people like. There's a brush on top and then a plastic cover. It's a multicolor face powder. I use it as a bronzer. This is a little black palette from Chanel. It's my mom's and she gave it to me. It's a limited edition from last year's summer. It looks like this. Normally it's supposed to be one concealer, one blush, one highlight, but it was a summer collection, so they put two highlighters in there and one intense red blush. All three is cream products. And that's it for this video. I'm really proud of all the makeup I own. I liked filming this video. I really enjoyed it. Maybe one day in 20 years, I will look back to it and feel proud. But anyways, it's time for eating now. I will see y'all later. Bye!